Hi everybody, welcome back to the Taxable channel. Today in this video I'm going to show you how to create a form reason to insert record into a table. So guys, before we get started, I will ask everyone to subscribe to my channel to get regular updates of my YouTube channel. So one more useful information I would like to give before we start, there's a book on Visual Builder, Oracle Visual Builder, which is written by me. If you want to learn Oracle Visual Builder along with the Oracle Apex, you can opt this book and start learning Oracle Visual Builder. So this book is written by me and I have written all these concepts which is required to learn Oracle Visual Builder. If you are interested to learn Oracle Visual Builder along with the Oracle Apex, you can go to this link https://pact.live/3mwsnr7, which will take you to the Amazon website from where you can buy this book. Again, Visual Builder is a low level code development tool like Apex to build web and mobile application. Okay, so let's get started. Like, I'm going to create a form reason which will be used to insert data into a table. So after completing this video, you will see a form like this, wherein you will see a one button. And once we click on a submit button, all the data will be inserted into a table. So let's get started and see how we can build similar kind of form in a Apex. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a page. So there are multiple ways to create a form. Like, you can start creating the form using a blank page, or you can use this form, and like, you can use form, editable, interactive grid, report with form, live view with web form, or form on a local processor. So there are various options. First option I am going to show you with the help of blank page. Okay, so here I am going to say employee, get employee. Okay, and that's fine. Normal, click on the next button. I am going to create a navigation menu entry here and let's say next and then finish. Now once your page is created, you will be landed onto this page, and here if you need to create a form which will be used to insert the data into a table. Like, I have one employee table wherein I have few columns: employee ID, first name, last name, age, employee address, qualification. So if you want to create a form to insert the record into this table, you can do it very easily in the Apex. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to use this page and I'm going to create a reason here. So click on this reason, and here in the property side, you can give a name, let's say new employee as a title. And then here you see the type. So we have various type, and one of the type is called form. So this form is a special type which will create a web form automatically based on the selected table. So you can select a form. When you select a form, it will ask the source information, which source you want to use to create this form. So either you can use local database, REST enabled SQL, or the REST source. So I'm going to use this local database. I will use type, and here I will select the table which I need to use to create my form. So I will choose this as an employee. When you select this employee, here you see all the items will be created automatically along with this process called initialize form create employee. Here you see employee ID, first name, last name, age, email address, qualification. So it will create all the web items automatically based on the selected table. You can see the layout. This is how your page looks like. Now employee ID is like a primary key which I don't want to show on my page. So what I will do, first of all, I will make this as a primary key, otherwise we will see an error. And then, okay, what error we will see, I will show you. Let's save this page. And then if you will not make primary key, then you may get this error like no primary key item has been defined. So it's mandatory to select the primary key and save and then run this. Now here you see employee ID, first name, last name, age, email address, qualification. Now, if you see, if you select a particular item, so I also don't want to show this employee ID, so I can make this field as a hidden so that it will not be visible on the web page. So here you see first name, you can select every item, okay, and then you can change the properties of it. Let's say this first name is based on the type text area. If you see, it's like a text area, but I want to convert this into a text field. So you can select a particular type. Similarly, last name is text area by default. I will choose a text field. Age is like a number field, which is fine. And here you see number alignment is right. Right means if you will try to enter something 1, 2, it will show the right. So you can change the alignment and let's say left. Email address, you can again say it's like a text field. Qualification, it's like a text area. If you want to make it select list, you can make it select list. You can change this and then it's showing in red because there's a mandatory property which you need to select here. Let's say type. So you can make you can use the shared component to populate this select list or SQL query or static value. Let me use this static value for the time being, wherein I can put the value like MCA. Return value is MCA. Let's say MBA and then same thing MBA. Let's say BCA. Let's say BCA. So I'm keeping three values as of now. Okay. And then save and let's see how your page looks like now. Here you see this is my page. Now here you see every column, every column, every text field is in a separate row. So if you want to utilize this space and you want the first name, last name in a single row, age and email address in a single, you can do this. So how you can do this? You can see this is how the layout looks like. So you see first name, last name, click on the last name. So what you can do, you can use this start new row. If it is on, then this field will come in a new row. If you can make it off, you see similarly email address and then make it like this. Save. Now I want to create a what here a button which will be used to insert. So let's say click on this plus button and you can say submit. Okay, button name submit and can select the reason as a new employee. Okay, and then you can save and let's see how your page looks like now. You can see submit, this is at the right side. How it is right side? Because you see button position below reason, you can choose create, change, whatever position you want to change. Okay, and you can make it hot so that it looks like in this format. Okay, and then the behavior is submit page and database action, you can say SQL insert action. So I have associated this button with this new employee reason. And here I have used this SQL insert action. So automatically it will insert the data. If I choose this action, it's fine. Let's save it and then run it. Let's try to insert the record. Let's say, and here we see this guy MCA and let's say submit. Here you see record has been inserted. Let's see. Oh, it has not been inserted. Maybe something wrong. Okay. Submit. Okay. So I made one mistake. You have to click on this reason and you have to click on this attribute. You have to make this enabled. Okay. And it will allow you all these options like add row, update row, delete row. So when you create a reason with form, you have to enable this under this attribute. Like you have to select this reason, go to this attribute and enable this. Then only it will allow me to perform actions. Okay. Let's see again. Can select this MBA and then submit. Now you see row created. Employee. You see mega has been added here. So this is how you can use form reason to insert the data into a table. So guys, that's all about this video. If you have any question, you can ask this question in the comment section. I will be happy to assist you. And if you like this video, please like, comment and share. And please don't forget to subscribe to my channel to get regular updates. You can find me over LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, and you can always see my blog https://www.taxsupper.com. Thanks for watching the video. Have a good day. Bye-bye.